August 5th, 2013 is when the accident occurred. Somewhere around 10 o'clock in the evening, don't know where I was coming from, my car was overheating and I noticed that the smoke was coming up from the radiator area. So by God's grace, I managed to go from the fast lane over to the shoulder of the freeway, and I parked my car, was gonna let it cool down. I noticed the truck swerving over from one or two lanes out and ran straight into me. And then all of a sudden, the car blew up. It was like within seconds. I was conscious all the time. When the ambulance came, once they rolled me into the gurney, I laid back. The next thing I knew, when I woke up, it was 6 months later. I can't put in words or describe the feeling while in a coma. It seemed like the Lord just He just covered me.
We were thrilled and our prayers had been answered when my godfather woke up. But what we didn't really realize is what we were up against. He was burned over 75% of his body, mostly upper body. He had lost his lips, a part of his nose, a part of his ear. He was almost unrecognizable. There's a serious lack of donors in the Black community and minority communities as it relates to the need.
It's so rare to find a Black face. We didn't know how rare it was. The night that I received the call from Dr. Pomerhoff, I asked him, "Is this real? Are you calling?" Because he said, "Yes, I have a donor for you, Robert."
The fundamental principle of all transplantation is that we recover organ, in our case it's the face, then we package it and cool it down and literally bring it to Robert, whose old scarred face is partially removed. And then the new face is essentially brought and gradually connected, the nerves, the vessels, the arteries, everything.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too, you look good.
Yeah, man.
Feeling all right?
I'm feeling fine.
Facial transplantation has a lot of risks.
How can you be the first Black person to have a full face transplant? Or how can you be the oldest as well in the whole world?
He came out, and believe it or not, he was already moving. There were already facial expressions. It was probably one of the most amazing experiences I've ever seen.
I'm still trying to get used to identifying with the new face, knowing that it did actually come from someone else and the family that was so kind enough to allow their loved one to share his face and the rest of his body with the donor community. The driver, he had 3 DUIs from what I understand, and he was given 4 years in jail. People have asked how God forgiven them. I don't see anything to forgive. It's just an accident.
A year out, I think Robert's doing great. He's progressing well from the transplant standpoint. The overarching problem that we're trying to avoid is rejection. Every patient develops a rejection. The body essentially is trying to get rid of tissues that it recognizes at given time as foreign.
The nerves are reconnected, but your brain is learning which ones are supposed to be controlled by what, and trying to differentiate movements with help of our speech therapist will help. You will still be getting better. There's another year that we know our patients are getting fairly dramatically better, and then at about 2 years from the surgery, that's where it plateaus.
Yeah. Anybody that has something different, I want them to have hope. Who knows what will be next, the day by day, new mercies unfold. This year, I'm not looking for Robert Chelsea. I am Robert Chelsea.